Welcome friends, welcome to another video lecture of Biovision Academy. And friends, today we are going to discuss about CD and ORD. Okay friends, students, the full form of CD is circular dichroism, whereas full form of ORD is optical rotatory dispersion. Okay friends, students, CD and ORD depends on the polarization of light. Okay, so students, if we want to understand about the CD and ORD, then we should have an idea about the polarization of light. Okay friends, so let's understand what is polarization of light and how it is related with CD and ORD. Let's understand this. Okay. Students, you know that light is an electromagnetic wave. It means light has two components. One is electrical component and another one is magnetic component. Okay, student? So let's draw a single beam of light which represents their electrical component and magnetic component. Okay, students, suppose that it is a source of light. Okay, and from this light source, light emitting in all possible direction. Okay, in all possible direction. So students, let's draw a single beam of light which represent their electrical component and magnetic component. Students, this is the direction of propagation of light. It means light is moving in this direction. Okay, okay. So students, these are two components of a beam of light. Students, this blue line indicates the magnetic component of a light and yellow line indicate the electrical component of a light. Okay, now got it? Now, students, the light beam which is emitted from a light source has three axes. One is x-axis, second one is y-axis, and the next one is z-axis. Okay, so students, a simple beam of light due to three axes is always in 3D form. Okay, 3D stand for three dimensional. Okay students, this is a single beam of light. Okay, but a light source emits several beams of light in all possible direction, in which both the electrical component and magnetic components are perpendicular to each other. Okay, here we have represented a single beam of light which represents an electrical vector and magnetic component. Okay students, the magnitude of electrical component is very high as compared to magnetic component, and due to optical behavior, or you can say the optical properties of a light is generally depend upon electrical component, not on magnetic component. So we generally consider, or you can say we generally draw electrical component and we just avoid the magnetic component. Okay friends, so students, in next step we just put a polarizer. We just put a polarizer in front of this single beam of light. Okay? Students, polarizer is a device from which only that electrical vector is able to cross which is in parallel direction to the polarizer. Okay, here you can observe that this single beam of light in which electrical component and magnetic component both are present, and this electrical vector is in parallel direction to the polarizer. So this electrical vector is able to cross this polarizer. Okay, students and students, this electrical vector now has a two axis. One is x axis and another one is y axis. Okay students, so this light after polarization is now is in 2D form. Okay, is in 2D form. Students, when a light emitted from a light source, then its electrical component has the ability to vibrate in all possible direction, or you can say it can move in all possible direction. Okay, suppose that it is a source of light and light beam emitted in all possible direction. It may emit in this direction, in this direction, in this direction, or in this direction. Okay, light ray may emit in all possible direction, and light contain electrical vector and magnetic vector, but due to high magnitude and optical properties, we generally ignore the magnetic component and we just consider the electrical component. So the electrical component of a light beam may vibrate like this, horizontally, vertically, this side, or any possible direction. Okay, so students, that beam of light which has the ability to vibrate in all possible direction, or in other words, you can say that the electrical component of a beam of light which is able to vibrate in all possible direction is considered as unpolarized light. So this light beam, you can call it unpolarized light. Unpolarized light. Okay, and student, when this unpolarized light incident on this polarizer, okay, then only that electrical component is able to cross this polarizer which are in parallel direction to the polarizer. Here this single beam of light represent electrical component and magnetic component, and you can observe that this yellow line which represent the electrical component is in parallel direction to the polarizer. So it crossed the polarizer, and now after crossing the polarizer, this electrical component has a fixed path of propagation. It means it is not able to move in any direction. It has a just fixed path of propagation. Okay, so students, the electrical component of beam of light which is vibrate in a single direction, or you can a single plane, or you can say the path of rotation of electrical component is just fixed or restricted to a single direction, then this light is known as unpolarized light. Sorry, this light is known as plane polarized light. Plane polarized light. Okay, plane polarized light. Students, you can also call it linearly polarized light. Okay, students, you can understand this overall process like this. Suppose that it is a beam of light, it is a normal beam of light, it means it is an unpolarized light. It is an unpolarized light, and this unpolarized light when incident on the polarizer, then this unpolarized light have several electrical components which are able to vibrate in all possible direction, and only that electrical component is able to cross the polarizer, which are in parallel direction to the polarizer. So you can observe that this yellow electrical vector is in parallel direction to the polarizer, so it is able to cross the polarizer. And now after crossing polarizer, this electrical component is now is in polarized form. Okay, is in polarized form. Okay, students. So students, what is the main difference between unpolarized light and polarized light? Okay, student, an unpolarized light is a 3D form, is a, or you can say it is a 3D light, whereas a polarized light is a 2D form. Unpolarized light, or you can say the electrical vector of an unpolarized light, is able to vibrate in any possible direction, like this, 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 or this. But when this unpolarized light, or you can say when an electrical vector incident on the polarizer, and when it is cross the polarizer, then after crossing the polarizer, the electrical vector have only a fixed path. It means it only vibrate like this. Okay, it means we have just restricted the movement of an electrical vector by the use of a polarizer. Okay, student, friends, you can understand this overall process in a different way. Let's understand that. Students, let's understand this overall process with the relation of ORD. Okay, suppose that student, as usual, we have a source of light, and from this light source, beam of light emitted in all possible direction. Okay, and as I told you, due to magnitude and optical properties, we generally consider the electrical component of a beam of light, and we just avoid the magnetic component. So you can call the electrical vector is emitting in all possible direction. Okay, in all possible direction. Got it, students? And this electrical component is able to move in all possible directions, so we call it unpolarized light. Unpolarized light. Unpolarized light. Got it? Now, students, in next step, we are going to put a polarizer in front of this unpolarized light. Okay, so students, suppose that it is a polarizer, got it? It is a polarizer. Okay, friend, Friends, it is a polarizer. Students, generally we used Nicol prism. Nicol prism or Glahn-Thomson prism. Glahn-Thomson prism as a polarizer. As a polarizer. Got it? Students, Nicol prism and Glahn-Thomson prism are generally made up of calcite crystal. Generally made up of calcite crystal. Got it? And students, apart from Nicol prism or Glahn-Thomson prism, we can also use tourmaline crystal. Tourmaline crystal as a polarizer. Okay, but students, due to high purity, we generally used Glahn-Thomson prism, because due to high purity, Glahn-Thomson prism gives better polarization as compared to Nicol prism. Okay friends, now, so students, when this unpolarized light incident on this polarizer, then only that electrical vector is able to cross this polarizer, which are in parallel direction to the polarizer. So you can observe that this yellow electrical vector is in parallel direction to the polarizer, so it is able to cross the polarizer, and rest electrical vector which are not in parallel to the polarizer is not able to cross the polarizer, and they are remain in unpolarized form. Okay, so now this is the polarized light. Got it? So student, this light is now considered as plane polarized light. Plane polarized light. Plane polarized light. Got it, students? Now, students, in next step, we are going to put an optically active compound in front of this plane polarized light. Okay, so it is an optically active compound. Okay, optically active compound. Got it? Now, students, the question is, what is an optically active compound? Okay, so students, that compound in which central atom contain four different groups. Suppose that OH, CH3, H, COOH. Then that compound is known as an optically active compound, and the carbon which contain four different groups is known as chiral carbon. Is known as chiral carbon. Okay, so students, being an optically active compound, there must be a chiral carbon present with four different functional group. Okay students, so it is an optically active compound. Okay friends, now students, now When this plane polarized light incident on an optically active compound, then this optically active compound rotate this plane polarized light in an anticlockwise direction or in a clockwise direction. Okay, so students, suppose that an optically active compound rotate this plane polarized light in an anticlockwise direction. In an anticlockwise direction. Okay. So student, that optically active compound which rotate the plane polarized light in an anticlockwise direction, then this optically active compound is known as levorotatory. It is known as levorotatory. Okay friends, and student, that plane polarized light which is rotate in an anticlockwise direction is known as left linear, or you can say left linearly polarized light. Okay friends, left linearly polarized light, got it? Now students, generally phospholipid, okay, generally let me rub this out. Phospholipid, okay, generally phospholipid and protein, generally phospholipid and protein are the levorotatory compounds which have the ability to rotate the plane polarized light in an anticlockwise direction. Okay friends, now students, that optically active compound which rotate the plane polarized light in a clockwise direction, okay, so students, suppose that now an optically active compound rotate the plane polarized light in a clockwise direction. Okay, so student, that optically active compound which rotate the plane polarized light in a clockwise direction, then that compound is known as dextrorotatory. Okay students, and the plane polarized light which is rotating in a clockwise direction is considered as right linearly polarized light. And students, generally sugars, you can say carbohydrate, are the dextrorotatory compound. Dextrorotatory compound which rotate the plane polarized light in a clockwise direction. Okay friends, so student, this is about the plane polarized light. Okay students, let's understand what is an ORD. Student, let me rub this out, okay? Students, what is an ORD? So student, an ORD measure the ability of an optically active compound. Optically active compound, OAC stand for optically active compound. So ORD measure the ability of an optically active compound to rotate the plane polarized light in an anticlockwise direction or in a clockwise direction. Okay friends, so ORD basically measure ability of an optically active compound to rotate the plane polarized light in an anticlockwise direction or in a clockwise direction, or you can say in a left-handed direction or in a right-handed direction. Okay friends and students, the instrument which is used to measure ORD is known as spectropolarimeter. Spectropolarimeter. Got it, friends? Spectropolarimeter is used to measure an ORD. So, students, let's see. Spectropolarimeter is used to measure an ORD and an ORD is used to measure the ability of an optically active compound to rotate the plane polarized light to rotate in a anticlockwise direction or in a clockwise direction. Okay, so friends, this is all about the polarization of light and about the ORD. Okay friends, in our next video lecture we will talk about CD. Okay friends, so friends, I hope this video will help you to understand about the polarization of light, about the polarizer and about the ORD. Okay friends, so if you like this video, then please share this video with your friends and please do subscribe our channel. And friends, please don't forget to press the bell icon, so next time when we upload a new video you will get the notification. Okay friends, so thank you for your precious for hearing. Have a nice day.